So today I'm gonna show you guys how to get a flawless three-stage blend, and we're shooting 070, the Toyota Blizzard White. And I'm gonna show you what I do and how I do it to get a nice, consistent, even blend with a three-stage. And we're shooting this one with the door off and the blend panel off. And then we got the quarter, and we gotta do the unicide here because this was damaged. So I'm gonna show you how to do that all apart, one shot, no cutting in, one time in and one time out, guys. So that's how I do it. And that's how you'll get to be the most efficient, is painting things apart and only painting things one time. So one time is for me, and I'm gonna show you how I do it and how I get a nice even blend with a special technique that I do. I've showed you guys this before, but I wanna show you guys again, so that way if it'll help you get a nice blend. So let's get into it. So we're all sealed up, and I used my old WS-400 Pininfarina for this one. I haven't used it in a while. We sealed the door. We sealed the unicide where the repair was at. And now we'll be getting into the base coat. So as I was doing this video here, setting it up, one of you guys commented and said, how do you make sure that your parts mash when you paint them off the vehicle? And that was in one of my older videos they were commenting on. So when you do a car and you paint everything apart, you definitely have to watch every move that you make, your distance, your speed, and how you paint that part, and make sure you paint every part the same. So you have to really be, you know, concerned with what you do and how you do it. So listen, I've been painting a long time, guys. So when you start to do these things, start out on something easier. And once you master that, move on and do something else, and then you'll get better and better. So there was times when in my career that I used to paint like 60 cars a week or better. So three stages, we used to do the two tones off the vehicle, and I'd have to measure everything. And when those parts went on that car, it better have lined up. So I'm used to working at shops that really demand a lot out of you. So it really got me good, even though it was a lot of stress. At the end, I gained from it because it was really pushing me at my limits and getting me better at what I do. So start out, try something small, and once you get that fixed and figured out, try something else. And just keep on sharpening your skills and getting better. So I paint everything off the vehicle, and I don't cut in anything on any cars, except for like when I did my True Candy of the House of Colors. That's a totally different animal than the stuff we're doing here, but this stuff here, there's no cutting in. It's all one time and done. So we got it all sealed up, and we're gonna go ahead and start basing it. And I'm gonna show you the trick on the blend. And I'm gonna also talk to you guys about making sure your distance is the same, your speed, and just getting better and better at what you do is what's gonna make you be able to do all these things and get you better. So the more gun time you have, the better you're gonna be, and the more you're gonna feel good about what you do on doing anything. So I have a lot of experience, and it's only because I've been doing it a long, long time, and I've painted a lot of cars through the years. So these things I'm showing you, take your time. If you're on that level, go ahead and do it. And if you're not, keep pushing your skills and getting better. And that's how you become better at anything. You have to fail to know what you have to do to fix it. So don't just do it one way because it's easy. Try to get better. Even if you mess up, you'll learn why, and you'll fix it, and you'll keep on going. So let's get into the base. So we got one coat of base, and I went up and I came down. So we really put two on. We're gonna let that set up, come in and put one more on. And now when you're doing the white, all you wanna do is make sure that you have full coverage on that. You don't have to worry about too much of distance and speed and all that, because once you're covered, because that white is gonna be a pigment that will be covered completely. It's not like some of the reds where the ground coat is gonna change that color. So on those, you definitely wanna make sure you put the same amount of paint on each part and keep it consistent. So you guys see that I have these stands here, and these are the innovative tool stands. And the reason I like to use these is because I can put these at the same exact height. Each part is at the same exact height on the stand for both the blend and the new part. So when I go to paint this, even though I'm painting this over here, I'm gonna be bending over exactly the same way because I'm at the same height that I would as I do this panel here. So all those things make a big, big difference, because you know, we're humans and the way we move is definitely inconsistent. So if you have something the same height, you're gonna have a better chance for that thing to line up and match. So having things at the same height is definitely what you need to do. And a lot of times when I used to do this, I would line these panels up in the order that they're gonna go on in the car. But like I said, I've been doing this a long time and I'm pretty consistent with my movements and my speed. And I kind of almost do a lot of painting to music. So I kind of go to the beat. So we're gonna go ahead and put another coat of base, and then I'm gonna show you how I do my blends. And it's to dilute them down. And I dilute them a lot more than anyone else, because with this pigment of this white, it's very, very strong. And you wanna really milk it out and thin it out to break those pellets up so you don't have speckle blends. And I'm gonna show you how to do that. So let's put one more white and then we'll get into the pearl. All right, we're fully covered now with our base. I went ahead and put another coat on. Everything is blended out just as if you were doing a normal blend now. You guys could see that blended out really nice. You know, your color has to be right no matter what you're doing here. So this color was checked, verified. You guys know I do all the spray outs. I have spray outs for mostly every color. And this is the 070. So I do this color quite often, and we blended it out. The blend looks good as it is, but this is one more step to give you a flawless blend. So I'm gonna show you here what I do. So you guys know this is the Ultra 9 water base. So this is the base clear for the Ultra 9, and it's just as any base clear of any line, they all have their own, and this is the 920. So you guys see that's a small cup, but it's filled up pretty good with that base clear. So what I do now is, and you'd be surprised on how strong this pigment is for this white of the water base. The water base white is a lot stronger than solvent white. And to me, you don't need as much in it to give it that blend. So you're trying to almost do a candy with the white, that way it blends out nice and easy. So I'm gonna show you how much I put in here. I don't get crazy with it, but I wanna do it like this, cause you guys see here, I'm holding this and trying to do this video for you at the same time. But I have it going in there, the paint. And you don't have to have a lot of this. You just wanna have some of the white in here. You'd be surprised on how little you need to do what I'm trying to do here with this. So I'm gonna go ahead and squeeze this and try to get a little bit more in here. But you guys see I'm squirting that in there. So that little bit will change this blend like you wouldn't believe. So you put that white in there. You guys get comfortable with a ratio that you do. I would say that this is about 75. This is about probably 95% clear base to 5% of the white, and maybe even less than that. So you don't need much. Now you'll go ahead and put your lid on, and we'll do the blends and I'll show you what I do. All right, so we went ahead and worked that blend. And we put a coat on all the parts and all the panels that we're working on in here. Do everything the same. And you guys know that that 9020 and any of the base clears have a little bit of a yellowness. That's why I don't use them when I do silver blends, because I've seen that they darken the panel. So I don't use a blending base clear when I'm doing any of my blends, as far as only when I'm gonna dilute the base out, and I don't take it to the end of the panel. So you wanna make sure you do the same thing, even though I just needed that stuff for the blend to help that blend out. I put it on all the panels because I wanna do the same thing and be consistent and make sure that once these things go on, they have the same thing done to all of them and I don't have to second guess anything. So make sure you do the same thing on them all. So now we have it all blended out nice and we're ready to hit it with our pearl. So this is where, now doing this job apart, you definitely wanna make sure that you have your distance dialed in, your speed, and how you do everything now is gonna be almost like you were doing a candy job, but not as crucial, because when these panels line up, you gotta make sure that they have the same pearl on this side as the same pearl on this side. So each panel's gonna meet up once they get on this vehicle, and you wanna make sure that you do the same thing. So you can definitely take your time, go slow, and make sure you count your coats. Count each coat from one part to the next. If you guys get a little bit lost, you could always put a little mark on here. Put one, and then when you get done, put one. That way you don't get confused if you're doing multiple parts in a booth. Sometimes you could go a little stir crazy when you got more parts in here. This isn't too many parts, but sometimes you could mark the panel. That way you know you definitely put a coat on, because I've done it in the past where I second guessed myself. Did I put another coat on? And it's always nice to know that you actually have it marked, so that way you know you did it. So let's get into the pearl. We're gonna be going slow, going nice and easy, like I always tell you, and dialing this one in. That way we get this thing done at one time and there's no comebacks, there's no cutting them in, and it's one and done. So let's go ahead and start pearling it. So we went ahead and we put two coats on. You've seen I was consistent. And one little thing I want to tell you about this, being I'm doing the outside of this quarter and this jam at the same time, don't come in here and hit this real hard when you're doing this jam. Go ahead and take it into the jam, let it mist in, and then come back in here and hit your bottom. And by the time you come up with the gun this way, it's going to be enough to give that effect. Because you guys know as well as I do, these jobs that come from the factory don't have as much paint in these jams as they do on the outside. So don't worry too much about the jams. Worry about getting your outside even. Because if you start hitting this hard, getting in here, and then coming up and wetting this up real wet, you're going to get this dark edge on the end of this here. So like I said, take the gun inside here. And then once you get in here, just come down here. And once you move this gun up, it's gonna dust enough of that pearl. You guys know that curl travels far and you'll get enough on that jam. So that's the way I do it. And it's worked my best for definitely having these things match when they go on the vehicle. So we got two coats. You guys see I was consistent, nice and smooth. And now we're gonna go ahead and put one more dust coat of pearl to make sure that these pearls are evened out nice. And then we'll be clearing it. So I hope this video helped you guys. It's done a really good job for me doing it this way with these pearls. And any color that gives you trouble in the water base and wants to fight you on the blend, some of them will get yellow, some of them will turn a different color on the blends. Milk it out, dilute the base, and blend it out, and you can really do wonders with it. So some of these colors you have to do that with or you won't get a nice blend. So I've been doing this a long time and it's worked well for me. So definitely a good thing to do on these three stages to get a nice blend. When you get this thing outside, you'll see nothing and it'll blend in beautifully. So let's go ahead, we're gonna dust it one more time and then we'll be clearing it, and I'll show you this one finished up. All right, guys, you see the blend looks beautiful, nice and flawless. Definitely a good technique to dilute that base and get that thing blended out nice. You break up that pellet and you get a finer droplet, which blends it out. So look how nice that blend is. And look at the front door, blended out perfectly. There's the new door shell we put on it. And this thing's gonna line up and meet up and match up beautifully. So I'm gonna go ahead and take a picture of this one and put a post up once this car is built. That way you guys can see the finished product. That way you guys know that I say what I do and that this thing matches. So remember this one here, this is a Highlander 070. We're gonna put a post up this week, early in the week of this thing built, and show you that this thing matches up. But it came out really nice. And like I told you before, this is how I do all of them. And I've showed you that before. So just get used to it, practice painting them apart, and all it's gonna do is make you better in the end. The more you test yourself, the more you push yourself to become better, that's all for you. It's gonna make you a better painter. So the more you can do, the faster you'll get and the better of a job you have, because you don't have any jam lines when you do jobs like this. There's no tape lines in the jams. Everything is done just like the factory. So nice, clean job, no lines, done one time with a flawless blend. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you got something good out of this one. Give it a thumbs up and look for the post early in the week of this one all put together.